Do you know, using M language, you can create your own custom function in Power BI. Want to learn how? Hi, this is Krupali from KnowHow Academy. So let me tell you first what you are going to learn in this video. In this video, you will learn how you can make your own custom function in Power BI using M language. Second, how to invoke custom function in Power BI. And the third thing, you will learn all these things using real life practical scenario. So let me first tell you practical scenario. Here is the data of a patient and you need to calculate BMI using custom function. Let me first explain you the scenario. Here you can see that I have a data of 20 patients. And here height and weight of the patient is mentioned, and also one more column is that is called what is the weight of the person or patient after 30 days exercise. So there may be a slight or major change in a weight after performing 30 day exercise. So what you need to do? Using this data, you need to calculate BMI, that is body mass index. And here you need to calculate BMI before the exercise and here then BMI after the exercise, but that things you need to do using custom function. So here I have calculated BMI before the exercise and BMI updated BMI, that is after the exercise. And let me tell you the formula of calculating BMI. If your height is in meter and your weight is in kilogram, you can calculate BMI using the formula, using this formula. So let's do that. So let's perform practical. So first of all, I need to load data from the Excel file. So let me click on this Excel workbook and sample data for M language. And here I'm loading data of BMI. You can see the column and the number of row are there, and click on load. Okay, I saved it. Now what you need to do? You need to create a custom function. Now how you can create custom function in Power BI using M language? So first of all, you need to go to the transform data. Then what you need to do? You need to take a blank query and write functions there. So how to write a function in M language? Click on new source and click on blank query and click on advanced editor. So here you can see that something is written, but let me tell you, we are going to write it from the scratch. But let me explain you what is custom function in M language. Custom function is a type of function which will perform the task which is defined by the user. The second thing that I want to tell you, that a function should accept argument and should return something. Let's say I want to convert my name into uppercase letter. So what I need to give? So I need to provide my name. So that is called input parameter. And upper function will return the value in a uppercase letter. So what it will return? It will return my name into uppercase. So this way custom function will work in M language. So first of all, how to write a custom function? So first of all, you need to define the parameter before the let. So you need to write the round bracket and inside that you need to pass a parameter. So basically I need height and weight of the person. So here I'm writing height, and after that you need to write what type of value it can accept. So you need to write S and then you need to write number. So it will accept number as an argument. Then second argument I want, that is called weight of the person. So I write a weight and then S number. Now here height and weight is called variable, and then you need to write equal to sign and then. Okay, so this way you can create your function which accept parameter. Then inside the let, what you need to do? After writing the let, you need to perform the calculation, or you can say necessary variable declaration, you can do that. So what I need to do? I need to perform the calculation of counting BMI. So let me take a variable, and the name of the variable is BMI, or you can take any variable, let's say where underscore BMI. Then you need to write equal to. Then you need to perform the calculation. So what's the formula of BMI? That is, the formula of BMI is weight divided by square of height. So that is height into height. And then you need to return the variable which contain the calculation. So here variable BMI I am returning. So whatever your function is returning, you need to mention it in a in. Inside in section, you can still perform calculation also. Okay, so it's your choice whatever you want to do. So here I declare variable with that calculation, or you can say with this value. And you can declare the variable using zero, and then here you can also perform the calculation. Okay, so it's your choice whatever you need to do. So, and let me click on done. Here you can see that enter parameters, and here they will ask you to enter the value of height and weight, and then you can invoke the function. Invoke the function means call the function. Okay, and my query name, with the query which I have made, the query name is query 1. So let me right click and rename it calculate BMI. Then whatever parameter I have declared, that you need to pass it. So let's say if someone height is 190 meter and the weight is, let's say, 56 kg, and if I click on invoke, it will do perform the calculation and it will return the value, that is 0.00 something. So that is my calculated BMI. And then you can see that the code which is there for calling a function or invoking a function is there. So this is your function and this is the result of your function. Now let's say here you can see that height and example 1, 2, 3, that is indicate that you need to enter any number. Let's say here in height I am entering any alphabetic value. So immediately it is showing an error, or you can say warning. And if you click it, you can see that enter a number value, that is showing by the Power BI. And here you can see invoke button is disabled. Why? Because you did not enter correct value inside a text box, and without the correct value, function cannot be invoked. And let's say here in weight I am entering 12, still it is not visible. Why? Because both of the text box should contain value which is defined. So instead of ABC, if I am writing 123, so automatically error will go and invoke button is visible, or you can say invoke button is enabled. Why? How it is determining that you need to enter a number? Because here when we made a function, we make as a data type number. Let's say if I do not enter anything and click on save. So here you can see that example 123 is not written. That means you can enter any type of value. And let's say here I am entering in this value, and let's say performing invoke, then it is generating an error. Why? Because if you try to multiply numeric value with alphanumeric value, then it will generate an error. So to avoid this type of error, always mention the data type while you are mentioning the custom function in M language. Let me click on this query and go to the advanced editor and write as number, and then click on done. Here you can see when you execute this query, what can be the result of this. So I execute this query 2 times. So first time when I execute, this is the result. Second time when I execute, this is the result, or you can say this is the error. So right now I don't require, so let me click on delete, and also I want to delete this. So my invoke function is ready. Then what I need to do next? I need to create one column in my data model which can perform the calculation of BMI. When I write this value, this is the simple calculation. But using this query, I want to generate a BMI. So how can I do that? So you need to go to your table, and here you need to click on add column, and then you need to click on invoke custom function. And for when you are performing calculation or when you are generating your column, what can be the name of the column? So let's say I can give a name of the column, BMI before exercise. Before exercise, okay. And what can be the query? So this can be the query for calculating BMI. So I have created this query one time, and the query name is calculate BMI. So automatically you can see that calculate BMI is there. Then what parameter you need to pass? So in this table I need to pass height and weight. And as you know that first I need to pass height and then I need to pass the weight. So in that sequence you need to pass the parameter. So height, and here you need to click that and select the column name. And what column name you need to pass? So here you need to select that column name. Now weight, let's say here from this column I need to pass the weight. So from this column it will get data for each and every row. So for first row 1.75 meter height and weight is that 70 is passed, and then the result is performed. Then for the second row, for the third row, for the fourth row till 20 row, it will pass the value and perform the calculation. So this query is executed number of row time. Okay, so here my number of row is 20, so it will execute 20 times. So here you can see that the BMI before exercise is performed, and you can perform the manual calculation and check it out, this value is correct or not. So this way I can make a function and invoke a function. Now let's say I want to calculate BMI after the exercise also. So how can I do? I can reuse that query and try to generate a new column. So let's say click on the add column and click on invoke custom function and give the name of the column. Let's say BMI after exercise. Then you need to write then select the query name. You can make n number of query. It's your choice. But right now I have made one query. So only one query, you can see it in a drop down list. And then you can see the select the column name, then height and weight after the exercise, or you can say weight after 30 day exercise and calculate. So you can see that this is the BMI before the exercise and this is the BMI after the exercise. So basically if you try to click on this column, you can see that this is the code which Power BI automatically written. Okay, so let me select that and click on advanced editor. You can see that for the function which you have made, automatically this much code or this much M language code is generated. And you can see that to call a function you need to write each. Why? Because I need to call function for each and every row. So here each, and then whatever the query you have written or whatever the function name you have written, here you need to write it, and then I am passing the two parameter, that is height and weight. So this is the respective M language code for function call. But what you done here, actually you made a function and by click and dragging and drop your M language code is generated. So I hope you get an idea how you can make your own custom function and how you can invoke using custom column. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as a source of your IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. If you have any question, do not feel hesitate to reach out to us. Stay curious, keep learning.